Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto sees the Senate's ratification of the country's participation in the Convention on Mutual Administrative Assistance in Tax Matters as Manila's newest weapon against tax evasion. The MAAC is a comprehensive multilateral instrument developed by the OECD and the Council of Europe. It has been signed by 147 countries and ratified by over 100. Recto said the MAAC would significantly improve tax administration as it gives government access to data exchange, assessment, and enforcement tools. It will also allow the Philippines access to tax information of other jurisdictions. The executive order banning all POGOs will be issued in 2 weeks. This is according to the executive director of the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, Gilbert Cruz. Cruz says the definition of terms has already been finalized, and the only aspect that requires fine-tuning is the operational concept and how the executive order will be disseminated. President Marcos ordered a total ban on POGOs during his third State of the Nation address last July. The move is expected to displace over 27,000 workers, but the Department of Labor has vowed to provide assistance to them.
Pope Francis visits Singapore's parliament on day two of his visit to the city-state. He was welcomed by Singapore's President Tharman Shanmugaratnam, as well as members of parliament and leaders of local Catholic Church. The pontiff was presented with a specially grown orchid, the national flower of Singapore, that is named after him. This is the last stop in the Pope's grand 12-day Asia-Pacific tour, the longest trip of his papacy. Republican presidential nominee and former U.S. President Donald Trump looking at another debate against his rival Kamala Harris. Trump said he enjoyed a showdown in Philadelphia. But as it stands, there are no plans for another debate between the two.
We had a great debate. We had great poll numbers on the debate. And we enjoyed it. I hope she enjoyed it too, but I enjoyed it. And we're looking at it, but you know, when you win, you don't really necessarily have to do it a second time. So we'll see. But I thought we had a great debate last night. I would do NBC. I'd do Fox, too. I'd do Fox, too. But right now, we have to determine whether or not we even want to do it.
A political inquisition. That's how former presidential spokesman Harry Roque described the House Quad Committee probe on his alleged ties to illegal POGOs and the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. Roque says the Quadcom should have stopped summoning him to hearings when Lucky South 99's representative Cassandra Ong denied he was the POGO hub's lawyer. He also accused lawmakers of going on a fishing expedition to link him to Lucky South 99. He claims he has already been found guilty by the Quadcom. The former spokesman's statement comes after the Quadcom ordered his arrest for snubbing its inquiry. Aside from his absence in today's hearing, the committee also cited Roque in contempt for failing to submit documents related to his companies and residence. Roque was detained by the committee last month for a day for lying on his failure to attend the first Quadcom hearing.
Ito pong si Harry Roque is actually a person with a two-faced attitude. Hindi lang po siya dating presidential spokesperson, he is also a former colleague of ours in the House of Representatives. At dahilan dito, we were very kind to him. In fact, our senior deputy speaker even asked him only to be detained for one day, of which he even questioned that. After being detained and after apologizing to the members of the House, Attorney Roque then went on Facebook and posted, and I quote, "In my view, the contempt ruling smacks of abuse of power and political harassment against an anti-Marcos Jr. critic like me," end of quote. Ay, napaka-doble kara naman pala ni Attorney Harry Roque, Mr. Chair. I find this disturbing. We cannot countenance such behavior, Mr. Chair. Naging mabait pa tayo sa kanya.
Aside from Roque, policeman Arthur Narsoles, who is linked to the murder of three Chinese drug lords in a Davao prison, was also cited in contempt for repeatedly snubbing the hearings. Meanwhile, former Davao prison warden Gerardo Padilla told the committee he received a call from someone who sounded like then-President Rodrigo Duterte, congratulating him for the killing of the three Chinese inmates.